automating a manual test case using Selenium. First session index, first topic, create a manual test case from scratch. Create a manual test case. Next, automating the manual test case using Selenium WebDriver. Automating the test case using Selenium. Next, exception handling for Selenium test case. Exception for some test cases only, exception handling required, not for all. I will show exception handling for the Selenium test case. These are the topics that we are going to discuss. Create a manual test case, automating the test case using Selenium. Next, exception handling for the Selenium test case. First, I am taking a manual test case, that is generic test case. Generic means it is common test case in most of the applications. Common test case in the most of the applications, not only in single application. See, I'm taking a manual test case. I will prepare from scratch. I'm taking a manual test case. That is generic test case. That is generic test case. What is the test case? Verify element existence in a web page. Verify Gmail link existence in Google homepage. Say, for example, as per the requirements, Gmail link should be available in Google homepage. Check it. Actually, it is live working application. It is in Google application in production environment. Actually, we don't apply testing on production applications like Google. Okay, for some practice you can apply. Okay, first I will prepare manual test case na sample test case template for manual testing. And one more thing, test case template may vary from one company to another, sometimes one project to another in the same company also. I am going to explain one model template. Follow. I will prepare this test case in Excel file only. Before that, I will explain the test steps, test case fields in this notepad. And one more thing, usually we prepare manual test cases in Excel file using our company prescribed format. Otherwise, if our company using any test tool like ALM, formerly Quality Center, or Jira for test management or any other test tool for test design. That tool provides test case template. In the template, using the template, you can prepare. Suppose if you are following manual process, using Excel file we can prepare. I will show that one. Before that, I will explain in the notepad. Test case ID. What is test case ID? A unique identification for identifying the test case. Next, test case name. Title or name of the test case. Next, preconditions. One or more. Preconditions. What is the precondition? Required condition for executing the test case. Okay. Next, test steps. Steps to be executed. Execution steps for the test case. Next, expected results. We prepare test case expected result using requirements. Okay. Next, just a minute. After test steps, test data. Test data. What is test data? Required input data for executing the test case. And one more thing, test data is not mandatory for every test case. Some test cases require test data. For some test cases, no test data. In this Gmail link existence, test case also no test data. Okay, expected result. We derive expected result, or we can prepare expected result using our requirements. Next, post condition. Condition after executing the test case. Precondition, required state for executing the test case. Post condition, state after executing the test case. Okay. Next, 8th field, actual results. during test case execution only we can prepare actual result. Next, 9th one, status. Test result, pass or fail test result. After test case execution, after comparing expected result with the actual results, then we prepare test case result, pass or fail. After comparing expected result with the actual results, then we prepare test case result. Okay. Next, last one, optional comments. See, this is a model test case template. This is a model test case template. Next, document the test case. Test case document. Fill the fields. Okay. First, launch the Excel file. Usually, we prepare test cases in Excel file like spreadsheet. If you use any test tool for test design, the tool provides test case template. You can use it. Okay. Excel worksheet. Okay. I am not using headings and file names, etc. Just format. Test case ID. Next, test case name or title. Next, third one, precondition. Next, fourth one, test data. Next, fourth one, test steps. Just a minute. Test steps. Steps to be executed. Next, fifth one, test data. Next, sixth one, expected result. Next, seventh one, post condition. Next, eighth one, actual result. Actual results. Next, status, pass or fail status, test case status. Next, comments. Okay, bold. Test case ID, test case name, precondition, test steps, test data, expected result, post condition, actual result, status, next comments. See, this is a model test case template for manual testing. Next, test case documentation. I will show in Excel only. Observe. First, test case ID. You can use any unique identification for identifying the test case. For example, TC001. Next, test case title or name. Suppose verify Gmail link existence. Next, precondition. I think none. We can execute this test case from scratch, from the beginning. Beginning means launching browser. So nothing. Next, test steps. I think for this test case only single step, multiple steps not required. Single step. What is that single step? Launch the browser and navigate to technical term Google. Just a minute. Google.com. Otherwise, you can say Google homepage. This is the single step. Single step. Just a minute. Alt enter. Okay. Adjust the fields. Okay. Launch the browser and navigate to google.com. Then you can verify the Gmail link presence. Single step in this test case. One test case may have one or more steps. Multiple steps not mandatory. Next, test data. Suppose if it is login functionality, user ID and password required. That is test data for login functionality. But this is verifying element existence, link or aid box, anything. Verifying the element existence. For verifying the element existence, no test data required, only plain navigation. So none, no test data required for this test case. Next, expected result. We prepare expected result from test requirements. Now, what is the expected result? Gmail link will be available. Gmail link will be available. Gmail link will be available where? In Google homepage. In Google homepage. Homepage. Adjust the field. Gmail link. Just a minute. Okay. Gmail link will be available in Google homepage. Next, post condition. What is the post condition after navigating to gmail.com? Simple. Google homepage with Gmail, just a minute, and other links, Google homepage with Gmail and other links, with Gmail link and other links. Okay. Just a minute. Gmail. Just highlight this one. Gmail. Okay. Next, actual result. Just a minute. Actual results during execution. Status after test case execution, by comparing expected result with the actual result, we can prepare test case result pass or fail like. Okay. This is documenting manual test case. Next, execute the test case. execute the test case. What is the step? Only step. Launch the browser and navigate to google.com. Just a minute. Launch the browser. Just a minute. In order to observe this one, just a minute. OI settings, tools, go to settings. Just a minute. This page. Edit. First use blank just for understanding. Open the new tab, continue. Use current pages. Just a minute, launch the browser. Okay. Again it is showing this one. Continue. Launch the web browser. Next, navigate to Google homepage. Suppose www.google.com. Okay, it is redirecting to google.co.in India server. Okay, this is Google homepage. Here observe manually Gmail link available. This is link only. Gmail link available. Okay, Gmail homepage. Okay, Gmail link available. What is our actual result? Just a minute. Actual result. Gmail link is available. Gmail link is available in Google homepage. Observe, Gmail link available in Google homepage. Next, compare expected result with actual result. What is our expected result? Gmail link will be available in Google homepage. Actual Google link is available in Google homepage. Sorry, Gmail link is available in Google homepage. Gmail link will be available in Google homepage. Expected Gmail link is available in Google homepage. Actual. So test pass. Comments optional. Suppose smooth execution. Just a minute. Smooth execution. Execution. Okay, this is test case document and we executed this test case. Test case passed. This is manual test case. Automate this test case using what is that one? Selenium WebDriver. Okay, documentation over. Next, test case execution over. Execution over. Next step, automating. Automating, just a minute. Automating the test case using Selenium. Observe, we can select existing manual test cases for automation, or we can directly write automated test cases using test scenarios. Depends on the project and our company management strategy. Next, we can start the test automation process at beginning of the project, means for entire project automation, or middle of the project, means only for regression testing, or end of the testing, end of the project, for maintenance testing only, based on the project and the company. And one more, remember once again, we can start the test automation process at beginning of the project, or middle of the project, or end of the project, depends on the project and the company. Okay, next, automating the manual test case using Selenium. Using element locators and WebDriver commands, we create test steps and use Java programming statements to enhance test case. We can use other programming also for enhancing test case, Python, Ruby, Perl, PHP, etc. But in this example, I am taking Java. So, and use Java programming statements to enhance the test case. Steps, first step, instantiate browser driver, either Mozilla, Firefox, or Chrome, or Internet Explorer. Just a minute, observe the steps. Step one, instantiate the browser driver. Instantiate the browser driver. See, Mozilla, anyone? Mozilla, Firefox, or Google, Chrome, just a minute, or Google Chrome, or Microsoft Internet Explorer, etc., Safari, Opera, anything. Just a minute. This is the mandatory step in every Selenium test case. Instantiate the browser driver. First, download browser driver from internet. Then instantiate the browser driver. Next, second step, create the browser driver. This is second step in our test case. It is also common. Next, third one. What is that one? Navigate to launch browser over. Navigate to Google. Google. Just a minute. Navigate to Google homepage. Homepage. Next, fourth step. Capture. Capture the Gmail. Gmail link link status. Link status. Next, link displayed status. Next, compare. Compare with, okay, compare. Next, generate the test steps using element locators and WebDriver commands. Next, enhance the test case using Java programming statements. Write Selenium. Selenium test case, or you can say test script. Test case or test script. Okay. Launch the Eclipse IDE. Minimize this one. Launch the Eclipse IDE. Eclipse IDE for writing Java programs or Selenium. We already added. See, we installed Java software in this machine and downloaded Selenium WebDriver Java language bindings, added to this Java project in Eclipse IDE. Just a minute. New. Why it is showing like this? Just a minute. Package. Create a Java class. Create a Java class. See, observe first. We downloaded Eclipse IDE and extract. No need to install Eclipse. Next, second one, download Java software and install. Next, set environment variable path. Next, last one, download Selenium Java language binding. Selenium WebDriver Java language binding jar files. And add those jar files to Java project in Selenium, Java project in Eclipse IDE. Okay, new class, Java class. Suppose class name, suppose I'm going to create test case, verify Gmail link availability. Verify Gmail link availability. Generate the main method. Okay, just a minute. Fulfill the first step. Instantiate the browser driver. Suppose system dot, just a minute, system dot, type yes, set property key value. See, web driver, suppose I am going to use chrome driver, chrome dot driver, close the double quotes. Next, value, path of the browser driver. I downloaded the browser driver into my e drive. What is the driver name for Chrome? Just a minute, type C, chrome driver. Just a minute. within double quotes, eDrive, Chrome, Chrome dot driver, close double quotes, already closed. Next, semicolon. Every Java statement should end with semicolon. First, instantiate the browser driver. Next, create the browser driver. Create web driver, driver. You can use any meaningful name, driver or ABCD. Driver is generic name. Equal to new keyword. We are going to create driver object. For creating object, new keyword required in Java. Chrome driver, open and close parenthesis, semicolon. Next, showing pink color, what is that one? Marking means import the libraries. Select this Chrome driver. What is the problem? Quick fix available. Oh, it is new project. Before this session only I created. I need to add Selenium WebDriver Java language binding. Select project src, right click, next build path, configure build path. I forgot this one. Next, libraries, add external jars. Just a minute. My Selenium downloaded folder, Selenium WebDriver Java language binding available in my C drive downloads. Open this one, select this jar file. Next, some more. Open this lib folder, select the all jar files, apply, OK. Restart the Eclipse IDE, restart. Yes, restart the Eclipse IDE. Now, select this Chrome driver, select this suggestion, just a minute. Now, it is showing the suggestion, quick fixes. Import Chrome driver from org.openqa.selenium Chrome. Import the Chrome driver library. Next, web driver. Import web driver library. Now, okay. Next, second step over. Create browser driver. Just run this one. It will launch the Chrome driver. It will launch the Chrome driver with a blank URL. Oh, what is the problem? Java state exception, driver executable does not exist. See Chrome driver. Path problem. Oh, mistake. Chrome driver dot exe, exe file. Now run the test script or test case. Browser launching with blank URL. Okay, now continue. Continue. What is the next step? Navigate to Google Home. Driver dot get, within double quotes, take that Google Home URL, google.com. google.com, it will redirect to co.in only in India, co.pk in Pakistan, co.in EAU in Australia, Australian server. In India, India server. Co.in. In US and global, com.com, commercial. Okay. Next, run the, run this partial code. Run this partial code. You can check the errors. No error. It is launching the google.com. Next, check the, capture the link status. Then we can compare. Otherwise, directly compare, but capture. It will increase the clarity. Capturing the status of the URL. Status, true or false, like Boolean value, logical result. So use Boolean variable. Boolean link, Boolean link status equal to driver dot find element web driver command of by dot anyhow we are locating the link. For link you can use link text. This is element locator. Link text is visible, that is gmail. Next, verification method dot type I is displayed semicolon. It will return true or false like Boolean result, logical result. Next, use Java conditional statements for verification. If link status, if link status, just a minute, if link status equal to true, open curly braces, true means exists, false means not exists. Suppose display statement SYSO control space enter Gmail, any meaningful message, Gmail link is exists in Google homepage passed. Just a minute. Okay. Next, else, open curly braces. Just a minute. All right, any meaningful message? Gmail link is not exists. Not exists means fail. Not exists in Gmail. Google homepage. Status of the result, filed. Okay. Manually we executed the test case. Gmail link available. Check with Selenium. Run the program, means Java program, or run the Selenium test case. Okay. Launching. Observe the output on Eclipse console. Gmail link is exist in Google homepage, passed. Next, after this verification, close the browser. Driver dot close. Close the browser. Run the program. Just a minute. Run the Selenium test case. Browser closed. Link is exists in Google homepage, passed. This is Selenium test case for our manual test case of verifying Gmail link existence in Google Home. Okay, we automated the case. Okay, it is working fine, But one small problem is there. Whenever you verify element existence in element existence using Selenium, if element available, then okay, it will show pass status. If element not available, then it won't show fail status. Pass fail, another status also there, error. Instead of failed status, it will show error. In order to avoid the error, we need to use exception handling. Then it will be the perfect test case. And one more thing, exception handling is not mandatory for every Selenium test case. Exception handling is only for some Selenium test cases, not for all. But for this test case, exception handling required. You check the second path. Suppose we are checking another link. Suppose that link is not available, then it has to show so and so link is not available, but instead of that failed status, it will show error. Exception. Observe this one. Observe the output. Browser also not closed. Observe the output. Exception. No such element exception. Instead of showing the failed status, it is showing exception. In this scenario, exception handling required. Use try catch block. Where? From this one. Try open curly braces. Close after if. If. Next, instead of else part, write catch block. Catch, open parenthesis, no such element exception. This is exception, no such element exception. Just a minute. Catch, open curly braces, close. Suppose exception name, any meaningful name, E. Show the mouse pointer at no such element exception. It is showing error, not error, suggestion. Import no such element. See here two libraries available. Import no such element exception from Java util, that is global exception. Next, import no such element exception org.openqa.selenium. Our exception is Selenium exception. Use this second one. If you use first one, error will be removed, but you won't get correct output after executing the test case. So don't use this one. Which one? Just a minute. Java util. Ours is Selenium. Import no such element exception from org.openqa.selenium. Okay. Next, write the error code. SYSO control space enter, short form for output statement. Otherwise you can type, for example, Gmail link not exists in Google homepage, filed. Just a minute. Okay, now try to run this one. We are using incorrect one. Suppose ABCD, ABCD link not available. Instead of showing the error, it will provide exception. Here I am not using ABCD Gmail, just observe the failed status. Run the program instead of exception. Browser also closed. Gmail link not exist in Google homepage failed. Suppose Gmail link exists, for example, just a minute. Gmail link exists. We already checked that one using manual test case. This time it will pass. If you provide exception handling, if link available, link or any element available, then pass. Otherwise it will fail, no error. Why? We handled exception. Run the program or Selenium test case. Browser closed. Gmail link exists in Google homepage, passed.